Hello everybody and welcome to another one of my videos. In this one we're going to be making another machine. The last machine I made was done with cogs. It was reasonably complicated and precise in its making, so I decided to make something a little bit more simpler and more functional.
Having made my motor testing pulley, I thought let's go back to that and just improve some of it. So the idea was to make a bigger one, and this one I wanted it to go on a wall somewhere so that you could crank it, wouldn't have to clamp motors down and things, and it would be self-adjusting on the pulley. So let's make one of those, and there's a few improvements on it as we go. So I'm going to need a board, and I've got some fancy chipboard. Find more or less the center so that you can get a circle out of it. And I'm going to need a bolt that is going to be my axle with a couple of nuts and some washers, and also a hole, a drill to drill the hole through the center of the board. Now I will need a plank that I'm going to secure it to the wall with, a little bit over the radius of the wheel I'm going to make, and cut that off. Now I will need a block for my bearing setup, so I want to take my bolt and cut a block the width of the smooth part of the bolt. Now I'm going to make my bearings out of a piece of pipe, and this is aluminium pipe, which is just going to fit over there, or not quite. And then I'm going to cut off a couple about that long, one for here and one for there. And I'm going to split them down the center. First, I'll just open a groove down or split the pipe. So there we have the two of them. Now, it's not quite fitting there, so I'm just going to get the screwdriver and open it up somewhat so that it will go on. And then give it just a little light tap just to close it back down again so that it is spinning on the shaft. Next, I'm going to put the two blocks together and put them in the vise and work out where I want to put my axle. Around about there, I think. Then I'm going to drill a pilot hole right down the center of those two. Now, with the drill bit that's a little bit smaller than the outside diameter of that pipe, I'm going to bore out that hole. I've also clamped it just to stop it spreading on me. Okay. So there are the blocks, and the axle with its bearings can fit snugly into that groove. And it has to be snug and not flush, because when you put it in there, there has to be a little bit of seesaw movement so that when we screw it down, we have the ability to tighten it should the bearings be a little bit sloppy. Now, about now is a good idea to drill a couple of holes in the lid as lubrication holes that you can put some oil down, face those upwards, so I'll show you later, and a couple of holes, two or four, just to clamp this block on. To give the head a little bit of clearance so that it doesn't rub on this, we're going to just slice a little bit out of there to give that some clearance. With the axle in there, with the bearings in and the grooves are facing upwards to align with the oil holes, we can now screw it down. Firm, but not too tight for the moment. Now we just put a bit of oil or grease down there to lubricate it, and that should spin relatively well. Now with time it will also start to bed in, because at the moment it's fairly crunchy, but it will bed in, and then you can tighten those screws a little bit to take up the slack. With it in the vise, we can now put that board on there and tighten it down. Now, in this case, my thread is not long enough, so I'm just going to do a countersink with a chisel. So now I've clamped that block to the table and put it on and tighten it up so that it now turns. Now with a pencil on the inside, I can turn it and mark out my circle and so I can cut that out. Then you go through the task of cutting your circle out. Just keep cutting corners off and keep cutting corners off until you've got a circle. Now to true it up a little bit, I'm going to put my saw here and then the spin and just grind off those lumpy bits. So there it is. Then as with other pulleys, we put a piece of board on, a thin board on there, and we're going to score a guideline around the whole thing. Flip it over and do the other side as well to cut the groove or the V in the pulley. Then I will cut the groove, put the saw on the 45 degree angle, cut this way, cut that way, and go right round to make the groove. And then clean it up with a little bit of a saw. I have a motor that I'm going to use as my generator, here it is, and I'm going to need a stick to mount it on so that it will pivot and give some tensioning. So I'll cut a piece about this long, and there it is, and I will also need to make a little clamp, so I'll put it on the same stick and draw around it. So I'm going to cut that to make myself a clamp. There I have it, clamped and screwed down, nice and firm. Now I'm going to take the same piece of stick and I'm going to place it on top of there and cut a V out so that is going to go in there and hinge. So I will now put that into there, not right into the groove, and then drill a small hole right through for a pin for it to hinge on. And a small nail from each side will probably do that okay. And that is gonna go there. I'll screw from the back that there so that it's going to tension here. There are a couple of things to do before we put it onto the wall is getting some thread to make a belt. Now this is synthetic thread, so I'm going to be able to put it right round. I'm going to wrap it round and just measure it and snip it off. Because the thread I'm using is synthetic, I can just carefully just melt that in a flame and then stick them together. As they cool, I can roll them in my fingers. Make sure you don't burn yourself because it does get hot. And there we have a joint that's strong enough to do this job. The other thing is take a little piece of broomstick with a hole down the center, a screw for a little handle, and I'm going to screw it there. It doesn't have to be too far out actually, because it doesn't take a lot of strength to turn it. Last of all, in my attic, I'm going to screw it to an upright with a couple of screws. And I connect my motor down through some wires up to 50 LEDs. And there we have enough light to at least get around the room. So there you have it, enough light to get around my attic in the middle of the night. Not too bad, pretty functional, but the trouble is that you have to keep on cranking it. So the next step is
to store some of that energy so you can give it a bit of a crank and then have a little bit of time to muck around in the attic and then get back to cranking it again. Next video, we'll look at that.